Are you wondering what social media platforms you should use for your brand or your business? In today's video, you'll finally get your answer. I'm still recovering from a cold, as you can hear, but that won't stop us from tackling that social media overwhelm. So by the end of this video, you'll know exactly where your target audience is hanging out and how to reach not only them, but also your business goals. So let's get started. Before we dive into today's video, make sure you hit the subscribe button and notification bell to get updates on future videos. And if you're new to my channel, welcome! My name is Yoka. I run a digital marketing consultancy agency through which I help entrepreneurs and brands tell stories in a digital world. And one of the things I see brands and businesses struggle with most is choosing what social media platforms they're gonna be active on. And so they just end up trying to do it all. And to be honest, they're just half-assing it. But at the same time, it's a very human and logical reaction to all this social media overwhelm. I mean, there are so many platforms out there, and they're still popping up left and right. And as a business owner or as a brand, all you want to do is reach as many people as possible within your target audience. So the question that I get asked a lot is, what social media platforms should I be active on for my business? To get to the answer that fits your needs, you need to ask yourself four questions. Now, make sure you stick through all four questions, because even though some of these questions might seem unrelated to social media platforms, in the end, you're gonna wish someone had explained it to you like this sooner, and it's all gonna make sense, I promise. Question number one is, why are you using social media? What is the end goal? Are you trying to get people to sign up to an email list? Or are you trying to make them purchase something from your website? Or are you just using social media to drive traffic to your blog or drive people to go watch your videos on YouTube? You need to figure out what your end goal is, because if you don't know, you're just gonna be winging it left and right without ever figuring out if what you're doing is actually working. Like I already said in my personal brand video, I want you to forget about vanity metrics. If you haven't seen that video before, I'll make sure to link to it up here. And I know it sounds counterintuitive, but I really, really just want you to forget about this idea of growing your followers just for the sake of growing followers. And instead, I want you to become super clear on what your end goal is. And then you have to reverse engineer it. What do I have to do to get someone who doesn't know me to eventually complete that end goal? And along the way, your followers will grow, I promise you, but it will be because of the right reasons. Which brings us to question number two. Why and when do people decide to buy or convert? How likely are you to trust someone you've just met with your personal information? Or how likely are you to buy from someone you've just met? Highly unlikely, right? And the same goes when people come across your brand or your business for the first time online. They simply aren't ready to buy it or to hand over their personal information or email address. On average, it takes 7 to 11 contact points or interactions before someone who doesn't know you is ready to convert. Now, there are ways to guide people to that point, but in order to do so, you have to know the different stages a customer goes through when deciding to buy or convert. And in marketing terms, we call this the customer journey. The basic customer journey consists of three stages. The first stage is the awareness stage. This is where someone becomes aware of your existence or your brand's existence. That can happen because they read about you in an article, or a friend tags them in one of your Instagram posts, or for example, someone shares a video you made with their friends or family. This is really the first contact point or interaction. But simply being aware of someone's existence or a brand's existence is not going to make a person buy. We then have to show that person that our brand is worthy of trust. And that's when we enter the consideration stage or the trust stage. This is where we as consumers spend most of our time, because this is when we're trying to figure out whether or not this is going to be worth it for us. Is this going to be worth it to invest my money in? Is this going to be worth it to exchange my email address for? From a brand or business perspective, the best way to build that trust is through longer form content, such as YouTube videos, IGTV, Facebook or Instagram Live, blog posts, basically anything that allows you to showcase your expertise, your personality or what you stand for. If someone then decides that they trust you and your brand and they want to exchange their personal information or money for what you have to offer, we enter the conversion stage. And this stage is completed on your personal website, a web shop, opt-in page, lead page, basically anything that technically allows someone to enter their personal information or complete a financial transaction. Again, this is a very basic version of a customer journey, but it should already show you that simply posting pictures on Instagram is not going to help you convert people. With your end goal in mind, you need to find a way by using social media to get someone from not knowing you to trusting you to eventually taking that action that you want them to take. Signing up for your newsletter, buying from your webshop, requesting a free call, etc. And to do that, you're going to need content that covers all those different stages of the customer journey. Before we can get to the holy grail of what platforms you should be using, we need to ask one more question. And that's question number 3. Who is your target audience and where are they hanging out? I'm not gonna ask you to define your target audience to a T. Although the better you know who your target is, the better results you'll have because you'll know how to distribute your content across the different channels. But in order to choose what platforms you're going to be active on, all you need is a breakdown of the following. First, you need to know what age group your target audience belongs to. You also need to know whether you want to reach men, women, or both, and where your target audience is from. Are they from the US, from France, from China? It matters. And then on top of that, it's always nice to know some of their major interests or why they're using social media on a daily basis. The reason you need to know this is because not every social media platform has the same type of user. For example, let's say you're trying to reach women in their late 20s or early 30s that have just gotten engaged. TikTok is not going to be the right fit for you. It might become the right fit in the future because it is a platform that's booming, but at the moment, you're going to want to look at Pinterest or Facebook, because Facebook also allows you to target people based on life events, such as getting engaged. To make it as clear for you as possible, I've created a free PDF overview of all the major social media networks and their user demographics. I'll make sure to put it in the description below, but let's already take a quick look at it. As you can see, Facebook has most monthly active users with 2.4 billion. Also, 85% of their users is between 18 and 55 years old. Now, if you want to target Gen Z, you're going to want to use Snapchat or TikTok. 90% of Snapchat users is 13 to 24 years old, and 41% of TikTok users is between 16 and 24 years old. Also, surprisingly, and this is why I've included TikTok, because TikTok is the fastest growing social media platform ever, it has grown to 500 million monthly active users, and with that is ranking just below Instagram and before Twitter, LinkedIn, Snapchat, or Pinterest. Then YouTube is also mentioned on here because it attracts 1/3 of all internet users, and after Google is the second largest search engine in the world. Now, if you're trying to reach professional users, you have to go for Twitter or LinkedIn. And LinkedIn in particular is very interesting because 49% of users has an income over $75,000. And then the last thing I'm gonna mention is that Pinterest is a great platform if you're trying to reach women with buying intentions, because 80% of Pinterest users are women and they use it as inspiration during life moments. So if your business centers around engagements, weddings, starting a business, Christmas, family holidays, buying a home, Pinterest is an ideal platform for you. With those audience demographics that we just saw in mind, we need to choose what platforms we're going to use to get a user or a potential customer from not knowing us to converting. And so we need to ask ourselves one final question, and that's question number 4. What platform is best for what stage of the customer journey? Now that you know where your audience is hanging out, you also need to know what platform is best in each stage of the customer journey. And this overview should help give you an idea of what stages each platform covers. As you can see, all social media platforms can be used in an awareness stage. But when we get to the consideration stage, there are certain platforms that are more suited than others. That doesn't mean that you cannot use Instagram, for example, in a consideration stage, especially now with IGTV, you can post longer form content on Instagram as well. But ideally, your own blog, YouTube, Facebook, or LinkedIn will be more suited for that. Once we get to the conversion stage, there are certain platforms that won't allow you to actually convert someone, simply because they don't have what it takes technically to do that. Of course, your own platform or website is gonna work best, but I've also left an orange check mark with LinkedIn, because as a freelancer, you can convert or get a gig through LinkedIn without needing the technicalities of a checkout or an opt-in. Also, there are orange check marks for Facebook and Instagram because you can, first of all, do lead generation ads on Facebook, but also because I know that certain brands are now testing the possibility of in-app purchases, especially on Instagram. So I've left those orange check marks for those two platforms as well. Hopefully this is all starting to make sense. I would advise you to pick the three social media channels that correspond to your target audience and the customer journey the best. It's always better to be really present on three social media channels than just winging it at all of them. Using this method and understanding the why behind it will also give you some peace of mind. You'll be able to say, I don't do Snapchat. That's okay. That's not my primary target audience. Or I don't do Pinterest because I'm trying to reach men. Or I'm trying to reach professional users, so I'm gonna focus on LinkedIn. Now, to make sure that after watching this video you don't get overwhelmed again, make sure you download that free PDF overview and just pick the three channels that will work best for your brand or your business. If you have any questions left, just leave them in the comments and I'll make sure to get back to you. Also, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button. That way I know I should be making more videos like this in the future. And that being said, I wish you a very, very fulfilling week and see you next time.